C-sharp records are notorious for their immutable nature. Everything in them is ready for deep immutability. Unless you spoil it, of course. But there is one tough question in immutable design which we must always pay attention to. What shall we do when there is a need to put a collection into an immutable type, such as a record? I will show you what makes that question a hard one, and how do we answer it? What do we do with immutable classes that contain collections? So come over here and look at my code. I've got two little records here, which are both immutable. I can use these types to instantiate immutable values. But what if there is the need to add multiple instances in a collection into an immutable record? Look at this one. It serves the purpose of a money account for a specific currency. But then I want to manage the deposits made to that account in that currency and the withdrawals. I have used two arrays to hold multiple instances of the money type, and I will tell you straight that I already expect issues with this type. Let me instantiate it first. I will define operations in the form of extension methods, which is a usual technique when working with records. For example, getting a balance from the account should be simple. It is a money instance of the same currency as the account, and then comes the calculation. I would iterate the deposits and sum their amounts up, and then subtract the sum of all the withdrawals made on the account. This was the read operation. It was easy to make, and it is even easier to use. I can get the balance of the account, nothing special. But the things will become more engaged when I decide to change the instance of the account, like depositing a certain amount of money. Let me first check that the currencies match and throw if they don't. And then comes the substance. The result of an immutable operation is always a new object. What I need to do is to substitute the entire deposits array with a new array with the appended instance, and of course collected into the array. So this is the basic implementation of an immutable operation, and you should already start feeling bad about this. Why am I instantiating the entire new array just to add one element? The troubles will come when this array becomes larger, and when I start adding items in the loop, that will be the performance bottleneck. But let's not rush. I want also to implement the withdraw operation. It will be the same. But this has a profound effect in how we use the objects, because there is no more an account. It is always an account at a certain moment in time. And there is no balance. There's always a balance at a specific moment in time. If you wanted to deposit money to the account, that would be a new instance of the account for the new moment in time. It will not disturb the original instance. If I wanted to withdraw money from this account later, that would be yet another third moment in time when I am observing both the account with its deposits and withdrawals and its balance, the new balance at time 3. Getting the balance runs in time proportional to the number of deposits and withdrawals in the account object. We say it runs in linear time. That could be bad. Why am I summing up all the deposits and withdrawals every time I ask for the balance? I could fix that. I could put balance field or property in the account and update it every time when I add deposit or a withdrawal. The entire type would remain immutable. But I have an issue with the deposit operation, which is also linear because of copying the entire array, and so is the withdraw operation. If I used mutable design here and had a list, I would just append a value to the list and that would take O of one time. If you know that the arrays are very small, like 2, 5, 10 items, and you're not doing this in the loop, you're not doing this operation intensively, not even every time somebody makes a request to your application, you shouldn't care. But what if there is the need to repeat, for example, depositing 1,000 times? Look, I want to construct the next state of the account at moment 4, but I cannot just update the state of the account. I need a loop. Inside the loop, I will deposit $1 in each iteration. Only after this loop completes shall we have the final T4 state of the account, and we will be able to get the balance at that moment and to print it, for example. The problem with this portion of code should be obvious. Here it is. Depositing would cost the time proportional to the bigger of the two measures, either the original number of deposits in the account or the new one we are adding. So it is a linear operation. When we do that in the loop, we get this formula. When the new number of new deposits is much greater than the existing ones, the time complexity of the entire loop and the entire operation becomes quadratic in M. You see where the problems are lurking already. What if it's not 1,000, but 10,000? What if it's not 10,000, but 100,000? With 1,000 items, it's just a moment. You cannot even notice when it happened. 10,000 takes a second, and 100,000 would take minutes, which I didn't even wait for. If you know that your problem is going to start growing in size, then the time has come for you to start using immutable collections. They will affect the way we design our immutable types. Instead of using a traditional collection such as an array or a list, we would use an immutable list of money instances here and for the withdrawals as well. And now I have finally attained full deep immutability of my account type. I have one additional note here to make. If you liked what you have learned so far, then please consider joining the growing community of supporters on my Patreon page. This entire channel is free thanks to the patrons. Every patron gets access to all the source code for all the videos on my channel and some other goodies that are not available on YouTube. So please join me and don't forget to like this video as well, and to comment if you have any questions. These operations used to operate in linear time. Now I'm going to use the add method on the immutable list, which returns a new list with one item added. The original list will remain intact. Immutable collections guarantee deep immutability. There's no reason to collect it into an array anymore, and the complexity of this operation will become logarithmic. We call this logarithmic complexity. The reason is in how the immutable list operates. It maintains a tree of nodes, and the height of that tree is proportional to the logarithm of the number of elements in the tree. So when a new node is being added, it only needs to rearrange a logarithm of n elements to create a new tree, and it will reuse huge portions of the existing tree. It will produce a new tree with all the nodes that already existed plus the one new. When number of items grows to 1,000, then logarithmic complexity says that the operation will take 10 new objects, not 1,000. When it grows to 1,000,000, this operation will only create 20 new objects. Let me do the same for the withdrawals, which will also become a logarithmic operation this time. Let me show you how that affects the places where I used these operations. Nothing has changed in the interface. Everything is the same, but the operation is different because now both deposit and withdraw operations become logarithmic. It remains that ideally these two could be O of one operations, but unfortunately that is not really possible with immutable collections. And let's see how that affects the loop, because the loop is where we actually noticed the delay. The inner operation deposit would become logarithm of n plus m. The entire loop would run in m logarithm n plus m, and if m is greater than n, then it becomes O of m log m. This is the book example of what we call log-linear complexity. You should love log-linear complexity. Linear complexity is perfect for a loop if the number of iterations is large, then quadratic complexity will start eating time very quickly. Log-linear is in between, and I have measured it. I have solved the burning issue for up to 100,000 items by just using the immutable list. Still, what if we go further? 1,000,000. I tried it, and this solution took about a second on 1,000,000 items. Can we do any better than what we did so far? Yes, here is the idea. Let me show you. You would not add deposits in the loop. No. You would collect them into a mutable collection. This operation takes a linear time in the linear space. And then comes the substantial change. We don't do an operation like this. No. We create a new account instance, which is the new state of the account, by modifying the deposits using the add range operation. It is an optimized operation. Do it in bulk. It takes a unit time to create each of the nodes, so it will take O of M time to create all the new nodes, and then a tiny logarithmic time to inject that entire structure into the existing tree. This will approximate linear time in number of new deposits. I want to show you how it operates on 1,000,000 objects. Look at this. You could barely notice that anything happened, and I did add 1,000,000 items to an immutable list. It's literally milliseconds. 1,000,000 items would take just a moment. 10,000,000 items would take a second. I measured it. But listen, where do you get 10,000,000 objects? You need to load them from somewhere. Well, that loading would take seconds. You can survive that 1 second if you already work on tens of millions of items, which you probably won't be working with. Immutable collections are really, really fast, considering what they are doing. So don't run away from them. Try them out.